Welcome to this short event from Origin Ministries. My name is Colin Peckham, and I have the privilege of leading Origin's teams in the UK and South Africa. The Origin Ministries group of organisations work in both countries as independent missions with a goal of uniting the church and telling people about Jesus. You can find out more about us at the website on the screen. Tonight, we are joined by Ellyn Oliver, Jamie Lang, Steph Macleod, and Reverend John Young, the Minister of Liberton Kirk in Edinburgh, Scotland, as we think about the events of Easter week. If you're watching the premiere on the 1st of April, feel free to jump in the chat and say hi in the YouTube chat window, and also turn on the subtitles if you would find that helpful. There is no charge to attend this event, but if you would like to give to support this ministry, there will occasionally be a link on the screen like this one, and you can support us there. The link is also in the YouTube description. Let's jump right in with Ellyn Oliver singing Arms Wide Open.
When I'm lost, when I'm found, when I'm trying to find my way, when I can't, when I can't, I don't know if I should see. Feeling low, feeling high, feeling somewhere in between. I'm slow, but I try, and I'm clear with all I mean. Who am I, who am not? I'm just putting on a mask. Too much, not enough, when I'm way too shy to ask. Flippy lines in my head, my laugh and my abhor. When I think that'll do, but I'm always wanting more. There you're standing, with arms wide open, and you already know, and there's nothing I can do to make you love me, to make you love me more. No, in the light all to see, I can look like I abide. In the dark, you and me, from your presence I can't hide. You know my thoughts, know my ways, going out and lying down. Despite that, steadfast, your love for me resounds. Though I chase after dirt, be the treasure that I seek. In this dry, weedy land, I fail cause I am weak. But your grace upon grace, of which I don't deserve, be my strength, water, quench me, all that I prefer. Cause there you're standing with arms wide open, and you already know, and there's nothing I can do to make you love me, to make you love me more. No. So I weep, so I thirst, knowing only you fulfill. In unrest, this I know, you're the calm and you're the still. It's you I seek, you I long, I search to no more. Cause I know that the answer is found in you alone. I love you, Lord, with all my heart, all my mind and soul and strength. Draw me close, fill this void, come and make me whole again. Cause I know, yes I know, it's only you that satisfies. In this power, in his name, give freedom from that lie. Cause there you're standing with arms wide open, and you already know, and there's nothing I can do to make you love me, to make you love.
Hello. The Thursday before Easter is the day the Last Supper took place. And the Last Supper is mentioned in Matthew and in Mark and in Luke, but it's not mentioned specifically by John in his Gospel. Instead, he mentions something else that happened. And I'm going to read it for you. It's in John's Gospel, chapter 13. It was now the day before the Passover festival. Jesus knew that the hour had come for him to leave his world and go to the Father. He had always loved those in the world who were his own, and he loved them to the very end. Jesus and his disciples were at supper. The devil had already put into the heart of Judas, the son of Simon Iscariot, the thought of betraying Jesus. Jesus knew that the Father had given him complete power. He knew that he had come from God and was going to God. So he rose from the table, took off his outer garment, and tied a towel round his waist. Then he poured some water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel round his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Are you going to wash my feet, Lord?" Jesus answered him, "You do not understand now what I am doing, but you will understand later." Peter declared, "Never at any time will you wash my feet." "If I do not wash your feet," Jesus answered, "you will no longer be my disciple." Now, why was Peter embarrassed? Was it because he didn't think it was right for a teacher to wash a disciple's feet, that it really should be the other way round? Jesus goes on to challenge this attitude afterwards, saying, "Yes, that may be the way of the world, but it's not my way. It's not my way of doing things, and it shouldn't be your way of doing things either. Rather, my way of doing things is for the leader always to be willing to serve." And I think that's a lesson for us all, particularly if we're in leadership. But I also think there's another reason why Peter is embarrassed, a reason that goes even deeper. And I think it's the same reason why so many of us don't like the idea of someone else washing our feet. I think it's to do with our sense of embarrassment and our sense of dignity and our sense of pride. We don't like the idea of exposing our dirty feet to anyone, especially to someone we look up to. We're anxious that it might change our relationship with them, that they might somehow think less of us when they've seen how dirty our feet are. And I think Jesus' response to Peter takes things to a deeper level still, because his response is quite blunt. He says, "If I do not wash your feet, you will no longer be my disciple." What does he mean? I think he's talking about our openness, our honesty, our willingness to let him deal with the parts of our lives that we prefer to keep hidden. And let me illustrate this for you by reworking the words of two well-known verses in 1 John. So here it is. Here's the reworking. "If we say our feet are not dirty, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we show Jesus our feet, he will wash them for us and cleanse us from all our dirt." Now, what those two verses in 1 John really say is this: if we say we are without sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, he is faithful and he is just and he will forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. I remember having my own feet washed in public once. It was after a long, dusty walk in open-toed sandals to a distant village in a far-off land. And as we sat in the shade recovering, one of the host family came round with a jug of water in a basin and washed our feet in turn. And I remember feeling a bit embarrassed when my turn came. But I remember thinking it would be a bit churlish to refuse. And so I allowed the man to wash my feet. And it was just my feet he washed. But afterwards, I felt totally refreshed from head to toe. It was an amazing experience. I think that what Jesus is saying here to Peter, and to us as well, is that if we want to know what it feels like to be forgiven, if we want to be able to enjoy the life he offers, life in all its fullness, then first we need to be willing to be open and to be honest with him about the parts of our life that we're ashamed of. We have to trust him. We have to trust that he won't think any less of us. And we have to let him wash us clean and set us free. Let's do it now. Shall we pray? Dear God, we thank you that in Jesus you have proved that there is nothing can separate us from your love. That your love is bigger than any of the things that we might be ashamed of in our lives. So help us to be open with you, that you might set us free. We ask this in your name. Amen.
I sail the lonely deep. In the midnight watch I keep. I stand amazed when stars on the billows gleam. And though I know a storm is rising, high above a dark horizon, I know, oh Lord, I know you're here with me. So let there be light, Lord, let it shine out of your heart here in mine. When it rains from heaven above, let it rain, sweet heavenly love. Let there be light, let there be light. There's a call on the restless tide, like a longing endless night. And it breaks the bow like a raging symphony. Though I may be far from shore, I am anchored at heaven's door. But I know, Lord, I know you're here with me. So let there be light, and Lord, let it shine out of your heart, here in the mind. Lead me out of the eye of the storm into the promise of the crimson dawn. Let there be light, sweet Jesus, let there be light. Grace is enough, grace is enough. Find me surrounded in an ocean of love. Your grace is enough, grace is enough. Find me here, surrounded in an ocean of love. Your grace is enough, your grace is enough. The crimson dawn, let there be light, let there be light, let there be light, sweet Jesus, let there be light, let there be light, oh Lord, let there be light.